I have bought the most extraordinary computer printer. It talks. It tells you when you are out of paper, it tells you the ink cartridge is low, and it tells you all of this in a voice of a general in the Army or a commander at West Point. Printing started, it says in a deep, authoritative voice when the printer starts printing. In fact, it says this about a second before the printer starts printing, and it says it as a command, after which immediately private printer commences to follow the order. Printing complete, it says at the end. I listened for what I expected would surely be one more command after that, but it never came. At ease, is what I expected. This printer is a $59 Lexmark Z11 color printer that I bought during a 40% off sale at some computer store. There was also a $50 rebate you could mail in, so I think I made money buying this printer. In fact, I bought two of them, have one at home, one at the office, raking in the money. Time to replace the color ink cartridge, it says when you are about to run out of ink. Leif Neubauer, who runs the Dan's Papers internet site at the office, set me up with a talking printer. He showed me how to do it at home by myself, too. Actually, the talking part comes on a CD, which you have to install on your computer. It's the speakers in the computer that do the talking, but it's the Lexmark printer CD that tells them what to say and in what voice to say it. The paper tray is empty. Will you turn that damn thing off, my significant other said sweetly the other day. Leif showed me how to turn it off, too. I don't think I have ever heard any device speak with such authority as this Lexmark printer. It stops all conversation cold. The people at Lexmark who designed this had to know it would stop all conversation cold, and so I suspect they created this voice as satire. It reminds me of nothing so much as Buzz Lightyear, or that character in The Muppets known as Sam the Eagle, or George C. Scott playing Patton. Is this any way to run a -$12 printer? You bet it is. Up until this time, my favorite voice has always been the one for Bell Atlantic, which is now Verizon. It says, "Welcome to Bell Atlantic." And for a long time, since Bell Atlantic came into business about the time of the Gulf War, I thought the voice was that of Colin Powell. It sure sounded like him. In recent years, I have come to learn that this voice is that of the actor James Earl Jones, who sometimes plays Colin Powell. One could run for president with that voice. With General Patton's voice, one could disobey orders, get the Lexmark to fire a nuclear weapon to save the country, thereby destroying it. It's the most reactionary thing imaginable. Thank God all it's in charge of is the printer. Before James Earl Jones, my favorite voice was the very irritated male voice that would come on the payphone when you failed to come up with a nickel for overtime. It would say in a monotone, "Please deposit 5 cents or your call will be terminated." This was the voice of a drone. We would do it, absolutely, and with no nickel forthcoming, he did. I came to refer to him jokingly to whoever I was talking to as the Terminator.
"I'll be back."
Another of my favorites is a small 14-story commercial building in Manhattan into which they installed a new elevator back in about 1985. It is a talking elevator and it calls out the floors, but it is so old and in need of such repair, at least the voice part anyway, that what comes out is mush. I figured the talking part was way ahead of its time, the manufacturer went out of business, and there are no replacement parts, but that's my guess. "Raoul Graumfke," it says when it stops on the 12th floor. "Honka Brutish Woofa Belitha," it says when it arrives on the ground floor. Everybody steps out. This is at 242 West 30th Street. Go in and check it out. But hurry, someday it will stop at a floor and just moan for a long, long time, and then somebody, probably somebody who has been coming to his office in the building every day for 15 years, will shoot it with a pistol, and that will be the end of it. Some of my other favorites are the 800 number for American Airlines, which features a lady so smug you can hardly stand it. She tells you the various options you can press, but underlying it, what she is really saying is that American Airlines is just so good that it most certainly is the best airline ever, and she is so lucky to be working there, and you are just so lucky to have called it. And of course, whatever it is you are calling about will be absolutely taken care of promptly if you will just hang on patiently until customer service representatives finish waiting on other customers who called ahead of you. So on the Lexmark, I got a new ink cartridge, took out the old one, and put in the new one. And neither Leaf nor I, clicking all sorts of buttons on the computer screen, have been able to figure out how to reset the voice so it no longer says every time you print. Time to replace the color ink cartridge. It's full, damn it, don't you get it? But he just goes onward and upward, wrong every time. It's enough to make you lose faith in Colin Powell.